I started here about 25 years ago. I started the last two shows of the 94-95 season. David Duchovny hosted the show. I was on a pre-tape making Guy into like a gray alien.
Job in the X-Files.
And it's my second day on the show. Jim Signorelli, who used to do the film shoots, he's like, well, you're about the right age. Can you just memorize this page of dialogue and we're going to shoot it? I'm like, okay. And I'm sitting in the makeup room and all of a sudden the monologue starts. I'm like, oh, let me watch this. And all of a sudden in my segment that they shot, they used the whole thing.
Dave Duchovny? No. The name doesn't ring a bell.
That was like the beginning of, okay, maybe it's a good place to be. There's two aspects of makeup for Saturday Night Live. There's the straight makeup aspect when the cast members have to look like themselves, just a little highlight shadow makeup change. But then there's the prosthetic changes.
Rudy, is that you?
Yes, that's right.
When I started that first year, we didn't do that many prosthetics. We had Bill Clinton, a little couple of noses. Everything was very small. One of the first things when a cast member comes on the show, as soon as they hired, they come to me and we do a live cast. A live cast is a plaster copy of their face. So when we sculpt whatever we're gonna sculpt, it fits them perfectly. For a show like SNL, when it's gotta be quick and it's gotta be fast, it's made to fit every nook and cranny of their face so we can just stick it right on. Wednesday's the table read. At around 8, 9 o'clock at night, we find out what 14, 15 sketches we're going to implement. At the end of that night, I'll know what needs to be built for Saturday. Thursday, we come in, we start building stuff for the show. The cast comes in, we do rehearsals all day. We're still building stuff, prepping stuff for the pre-tapes. Then comes Friday, we'll have pre-tapes in the morning, pre-tapes in the afternoon, pre-tapes in the evening, while we're also doing rehearsals for the show. I won't find out the exact running order of the show till Saturday. So it will come in, they'll reorganize the schedule, and it's like, oh, I got 5 minutes to do that makeup. Cold open scripts we find out like late Friday night. So for Mitch McConnell, I find out 1 o'clock in the morning, Beck is gonna be Mitch McConnell. I come in at 6 a.m. that morning. I took out a bunch of photos of Mitch McConnell, took a photo of Beck. I take out his live cast and start building up with clay what the makeup is gonna look like. I think that day I had about 2 hours to sculpt it. Once I get it to a proper shape and form, I'll make a mold on top of that. We'll take resin and fiberglass and put that on top of the mold. Once that's all dry, open that whole thing up, clean out the clay, and we have a positive and a negative mold. We fill that with silicone, close it up, let it sit for about an hour, pop it open, and we'll have our prosthetic appliances. You still saw it was Beck, but whatever he does with his neck was just amazing. It was like, oh man, that's Mitch McConnell.
Mitch McConnell here. Mitch, how are you feeling?
That was awesome! Woo!
One of the big challenges every week is turning Kate into some new figure.
You won't get a push-in, Jeff.
Oh, I know, because I'm a sneaky, lying little villain.
Turning her into Shud, oh my God, that's one of my favorites.
I'm mostly gelatin.
We're okay. Sitting at the table reading, and they come over like, oh, this is a blobfish. I'm like, and you want Kate to look like this, how? And then all of a sudden, oh, Scarlett Johansson's hosting. Let's turn her into an anglerfish.
What's that?
It's the challenge of creating the look that will sell the character, but not losing the cast member that's underneath that look. So many things that we put our heart and soul in, and then it gets cut. I think my first like few years, it tore me up. Like we would put so much work, so much effort into the stuff, and then they'd cut and you're like, I was heartbroken, but now I'm like, all right, what can I do?
What up, kid? How you living, kid?
Just recently we did this sketch. Awkwafina was our host that week. She's Cleopatra's makeup artist and she's talking her into the Cleopatra eye. So in the sketch it's written that they cut away and then they cut back and she's got the full Cleopatra eye makeup. And in the script she has like 30 seconds. It had to be a rubber stamp that was custom fit to her face, would just kind of press, transfer and peel off. Between dress and air, Steve's like, okay, so I cut out the video, I cut out this, only gonna be 10 seconds. I'm like, no, give me 15, a little bit more.
Now let's try something new with your makeup.
Fine, they can start.
They cut away, I step in, press it on her face.
Send me to a vomitorium.
Step out, she's got the full eye makeup on.
We're back.
Okay, what do we think?
Wait, Emmy?
Quick changes are the changes that take place during a commercial break.
Live from New York,
3, 2, 1.
Announce.
Sometimes they're done out on the floor. Half the time you're in the dark, half the time you got a little bite light in your mouth, and yeah, you're trying to glue stuff on, change people up, because there's only a commercial break to get them into their next character. I've had mustaches pop and beards fall off.
I know that your damn mustache is hanging off, I know that.
Just recently we had one with Harry Styles and his beard started popping off in the middle of the sketch. And I'm just sitting there like cringing. I'm like, I don't think anybody else sees it, but I see it starting to slowly go and I'm like, cut away, the sketch is almost over.
Everybody north and south.
I'm cringing and I'm like, all right, well, it's live, can't do nothing. I've had a 6-minute bald cap record forever. I haven't been able to do it faster than 6 minutes. Will Ferrell, we did in 6 minutes. Seth MacFarlane, we did in 6 minutes. Kevin Hart, we had to make him bald in a commercial break.
Shaq of Free.
With Mikey, we were able to do a full vinyl bald cap in about 4.5 minutes from scratch. I usually let them know beforehand, I'm like, listen, we've got 4 minutes to do this cap. And it's like all hands on deck. There's like 5 people, hands flying. It's really something to see.
Thank you.
I love it. It's choreographed mayhem is what I call it. It's really fun.